Well, it should be working. In theory. This is pre-show. Whoop-de-doo. Live on YouTube. Let's pop out that chat window. And I'm going to await some of my fine viewers to make sure the audio and the video are okie dokie. Okay. April 10th, 9:53. Just a little bit of pre-show action here. And we should be good. I'm pressing buttons right now, so bear with me. My subwoofer just popped in the living room. Doesn't sound good. Matt Keek in the house. Tanner in the house. Tanner's clicking on my face from Canada. Thank you, Tanner. How's the grease level? I did clean up for y'all. By the way, is the audio and video quality okay? Do we hear gongs? Audio all good? The mic muted? I don't know. Looks like everything is working. So y'all let me know if this crap is working right. And I set it to a little bit of a lower latency, so it should be a little bit more interactive. Matt Keek says all good. All right, all good. Whoop-de-doo. That's right. Good. It's good. We like that. Oh, what a lineup. Oh my God. The great Ron Knights. I'm gonna give him a big gong. The great Ron Knights is alive and well and in the house. Good to see you, Ron. I know this is past your bedtime. In the same breath, it's also past my bedtime too. I'm old just like you. Yes, not just wow, Ron freaking Knights. It's the great Ron Knights. Matt Geek, how are you doing? I liked your wave hello icon, whatever you call it. Emoji. It's funny, you know, back in the old days, you know, we didn't write LOL, we wrote ha. We wrote ha-ha. Rod says he already had a big gong. I don't know if that means tongue in cheek for bong or bowel movement, Ron. I'll guess bowel movement. What the hell? But see, it's really good because when Ron Knights is in the house, the great Ron Knights, I'm not the oldest guy in the room, so all good. But I'm glad you're doing well, Ron, and thanks for tuning in. I would like to schedule you as a future guest caller. So we can get an update in the world of Ron. Nice. And just a time and date stamp this thing. It's April 10th, 9:56 p.m. Whoop-de-doo. Ghost, how are you? Tanner says, no, you just... just Silver Fox, right? No. The gal has been cutting my hair for the last 20, shit, how long is Malia? About 25 years. She says it's not gray, it's not, it's platinum, it's good. Hi, Sam, how are you? I am doing well. Okay, I'm just, My nephew-in-law, we've been migrating his photos library, so I'm just responding back to him. But yeah, everything is going good. Sam, thank you for asking. Wolf, right? Oh, Wolf, we do the official shout out for Station WFCK, where I really dig into the microphone, so you get the full acoustics of it. At 10 p.m. at the official start time. This is the wonderful pre-show to shake out technical difficulties, which I still have. All this equipment, just I did a lot of cleanup on the equipment. I did a lot of dusting too. It's good. But yeah, we will give that a shout out. Oh no, you're gonna hear it at 10. You're gonna hear it a couple of minutes. Big deal. 9:57 p.m. Right, official pre-com. Knock it off, Tanner. Hey, Tanner, by the way, I know you're up in Canada. How's your weather situation there in Fahrenheit, of course? Are you getting a little bit warmer up there now? I don't think it was necessarily a big freeze your balls off winter, which is good. But I know Canada can get sometimes extremely cold. And I hope you all are doing well and appreciate you all tuning in. I do this for you. Where's Gasper? Someone text him. Are you going to be in the new GTA 6? Yeah, they should have put me in GTA 6. That picture of me standing by the ZR1 Corvette was like right out of the game. Danny Minnick in the house. What a lineup we have tonight, too. Major guest stars, as always. Ghost, sorry, I have to hear it. What's the proper way to pronounce? All right, so he's asking me, what's the proper way to pronounce Motorola? All right, well, there's a proper way in the way I pronounce it. Usually I stick an R on the end of things ending in an A. So I would say Motorola. But it would be more so Motorola. There's no, like, you know, Cousin Teresa and the Lisa. Tanner says it's a breezy 45. Oh, okay, that's a little nippy. Nippy. Yeah. Oh wow. There's Chris with a K. Frank Scorsese is my favorite niece's husband. She's gonna get pissed now. Chris, as you know, you're my favorite nephew-in-law, so it's all good. We're going to talk a little bit about Chris with a K, and some tweaks we're doing to his computer. So all right, it's 10. Here we go. Are you ready? I'm going to do it.
Welcome to station WFCK. The only thing missing is you.
We got to throw in the gong. So there we go. Listen, Wednesdays are the new Thursdays. I used to do this crap Thursday night at 9 p.m. 9 p.m. I shifted it to Wednesday at 10 p.m. This gives me an opportunity to wind down a bit. I was able to get a workout in and even a little swimmy poo in the pool. Nice. And I didn't have to rush. So there you go. You need 10 p.m. synthesizer sounds. I'll press a button. What a great sound, right? Oh, I have to announce tonight's non-sponsor. All right? Tonight's non-sponsor is Tree Farm. Do you believe that they've made this thing? Tree Farm Balsam Fir Scented Soap. So when you want your asshole to smell like a Christmas tree, you can actually use this freaking soap. I think I might send it to David DeFranco. He'd probably really appreciate this. I got it at like what did I get? I got TJ Maxx. Unbelievable. I bought two. Yeah. So we have tonight's non-sponsor. Wolf says we should have his podcasts as a custom radio station on GTA 6. Right. Just bring out the archives. Absolutely. Oh, you got the screenshot. Good, Tanner. You're on the ball. B-A-W-L. Is it pine tar soap? I guess it is. Is balsam, B-A-W-L, S-U-M, spelled the way I pronounce it. It is scented soap. It smells like a freaking Christmas tree. It's unbelievable. I love... Come on. Look at the packaging. That's unbelievable. It has like a little tree. You can use it to scrub your anus. Wrecked him. Damn near killed him. By the way, where's Gasper or the Klingon princess? Are the fine moderators here? Vin, are you here? Danny's here. There you go. Imagine having Shadows on GTA 6 while listening to Alfred stream on a custom radio station. Yeah, it would be wonderful. It would be wonderful. Anyway, so what we got tonight? Vin Dory is going to call in on the Skype number, and he's going to give us an update on the conspiracy theories, because as you know, there was a shit ton of them. I really would like to reverse engineer how we can link them all together. We can link in the bridge collapse, the cargo ship, P. Diddy, tunnels, the lightning strike on the Statue of Liberty, CERN doing a particle physics experiment, the eclipse, not Mitsubishi. Everyone was going, not everyone. The nut jobs are going nuts with this stuff. I went into Ace Hardware to get a hose. You say, what was her name? No, a nozzle for the garden hose, because someone keeps on stealing it at the freaking condo. I got to wash my cars and the nozzle's not there. And I asked the cashier, are people like stocking up on stuff? And she's like shaking her head saying yes. So some people went like wacko with the events. But, you know, listen, we knew about the eclipse. We predicted it years ago. What's the big deal? It's the way the system works. There is a wilder crap load of games and extra controllers. There is you're quoting from the Xbox 360 launch video. Yeah. Let me ask you something, because a lot of you watched that video. I was thinking about upscaling it to high definition, maybe even making a director's cut version. I don't know if there's really much extra footage. And then re-uploading it, but I don't know if it would take away from the charm of the original upload date of 2006 or whatever it was, with all the comments. I don't know. Would you want to see it in better quality? Or maybe I keep them both up. What the hell? But yeah, so tonight's lineup, Vin's going to call in a bit and just give us an update on the conspiracy theories. And then Danny Minnick's going to call in a little bit later on and do a little bit of a tech update. But since my nephew-in-law Chris with a K is here, let me just talk about what we're doing. He has a MacBook Air, an Intel-based MacBook Air. It has a 512 SSD SSD, and his lovely wife, my niece, they're expecting a little baby boy, duty machine, in August. So they're starting to put some thought now on photography and videography for the new duty machine. Now, they're noodling thoughts about a camera, whether they're going to use a current iPhone 13s or upgrade their phones or get a standalone point-and-shoot camera. But even as the precursor, and remember, whenever I say the word precursor, you have to drop a curse. Fuck you. So the precursor to that, though, of course, is workflow. All right. So the first thing, we had to move Chris's photos library off to an external, because the internal drive is kind of choking out. And we're probably going to move Alexa's photo library to an external as well. We partitioned it under APFS. What does APFS stand for? Apple what? What is the... Oh, and Gasper's in the house. Yes, we said MacBook Air. What is APFS? And what's up, Cap Toro 27? How are you? Go says, it felt nice to wash the car and put the summer tires back now that the winter's pretty well over here in Ontario. Oh, yeah, the swapping of the tires. That's like a vlog. All right, so Hummel says it's better just to keep it as the original. I'm kind of going that way too. Yeah. Marble. All right, so APFS, Apple File System. Well, that was pretty easy. All right, so listen, as you know, whenever we talk about an acronym, APFS, Apple File System, please reverse engineer it. Oh, hi, Corey. Please reverse engineer it into something rude, vulgar, and disgusting. This fine, sophisticated, educated, tech-centric, mature audience that you all are. Joe in the house. He went with ass proprietary file system. Vin went with anal prolapse. Fucking sucks. God. We're so bad. Anal fucking sucks. All right. Okay. Anyway, the next phase for Chris with a K and his lovely wife, my niece, is I shipped him an Apple time capsule. I had a 3 terabyte time capsule. I think it's fourth generation. And so the next phase is to like back up everything. And then we can talk about getting some type of a RAID array or something like that. So they can start loading up with footage. And hi, Mark. Oh, hi. Yes. Goes with anal particulate filtering system, anus profile system. Yeah, it's just terrible. Gastro, yours always are just so unique. You have to reverse engineer them. Yeah, and you wonder why YouTube shadow bans this crap. Anyway, so Chris, we still have to talk about, you know, what you guys are going to decide on with regard to a camera. But like I said, we should be close to getting everything set up as far as backing up, you know, clearing out room on the internal drive and backing the thing up. So when the time capsule comes, which it should be arriving tomorrow, maybe tomorrow night or Friday, we'll chat. Anyway, a couple of things. I had a visit from Dave DeFranco and his wife. David didn't make it down, but Dave Sr. and Deb made it down. They stayed at the Embassy Suites right next door to me. And it was so nice that they came down to visit. And now they're up in Orlando visiting some of the family members, the daughter, son-in-law, and their granddaughter. But we had a lot of fun and a lot of laughs and a nice FF class meal. I do have a couple of pictures. And they sell, like I said, very nice. I was able to celebrate their 40th with them. And and last night I celebrated my friend Lisa. It was her birthday. Her and her husband came over, and listen, you know, got some nice flowers and a happy birthday Lisa thing. Went to the Italian bakery, Joseph's Italian Bakery. They make some really good FF class, high sugar, high caloric stuff. And I got some the tri-colored cookies or the pride cookies, the rainbow cookies, whatever you want to call them. And some other thing, I don't know what it was. It was like an amorphous blob, but it was soft and it was really good. And I shoved the candle in it. And but it was funny, when I was at the Italian bakery, the fellow behind the counter had 777 tattooed on his neck. Now, I know what that is. It's the opposite of 666, yeah, angel numbers. I mean, I know what it means. So I'm looking at him as he's, you know, getting my order ready. And I go, hey, what area code is that? And he goes, oh, it's not an area code. It's angel numbers. I'm like, I know. I'm just being an asshole. And he starts laughing. He goes, by the way, that was the funniest thing anyone has ever said to me regarding the tattoo. I go, look. If someone asks you what it means in the future, you might want to say it's an area code, Compton, California. So, like, you know, Compton represents. All good. All good. Oh, Bobby Warren in the house. Bobby, you missed it. Hopefully you were here when I said that Dave DeFranco was down visiting. Yeah, right, Liam. Yes, the Embassy Suites. Correct. Chris, are you going to go to a 16 Pro Maximus? That's a nice, that's going to be good. Yeah. So of course, Bobby Warren, you know, I have to ask you, did you have any tech fails? So anyway, so we had a nice time celebrating the birthday and all good. Let's show a couple of pictures. It's a random mix. Nothing in particular order. If Ron Knights is still in the room, he's going to get a kick out of the first one. Let's go to preview. We do that slow fade out. All right, anyone that's old, like me, will find humor in this picture of Dr. Smith from, you know, my favorite TV show when I was a kid, Lost in Space, and he sees the Starship Enterprise rolling up in the front. But all good. What's the next picture? Let's go next. Okay, good. Scam text. Dear Linda, I'm Nicole. Who the hell writes a text message, Dear Linda, I'm Nicole? I mean, these scammers are really not good. Not impressed with any of them. And then I got this one. Hello, how are you today? And let's just look at the picture. All right. I mean, this is probably AI generated, you know, I mean, it's like either that or it's just like stock photo. Let's get your beautiful stock photo Asian gal in there. Nice. Again, not impressed. I did attend, my friend Aziz invited me to attend his mosque on Friday night. Break fast with him. And it was really an interesting experience. I went with the proper protocol garb. So there is the proper shirt, simple black pants. I got rid of all the, you know, Italian gold chains and whatnot. But it was really a very, very interesting experience. I really enjoyed it, and very communal. And it was nice, you know, like I said, supporting my friend. And I'll tell you one thing, I did the fast. So the deal is you have to eat your breakfast before sunrise and then nothing, like no water during the day. And then when the sun sets, then you can eat. And so I did it for one day. I don't know. Got to be tough doing that for a whole month, especially with an eating disorder. I loved it. I like eating and I can't stop. So, but I did the fast and it was good. This is an event I'm going to on Saturday. A local event. It's a retro, like Florida Retro Computer Club. All right. So this should be real interesting. And we're zooming in. We're looking at Apple IIcs and all types of old crap. This should be a real interesting crowd to talk about the old stuff. Let's see. Another scam text. What's the next? Another scam text there. Hello, this is Tina. Are you from dating site? Can we chat? Again, not impressed. Not impressed. All right, so photo. Dave DeFranco Sr. with his lovely wife, Deb. Right near my, you know, at my condo. The beach. Beautiful shot. And, you know, it was really pretty cool because Deb and Dave were saying, Alfred, you know, you're so blessed. You experience this every day. And yeah, it's great. I love waking up to the ocean and seeing sunrise and sunsets. Good stuff. All right. So then we had to do the obnoxious selfie. I'm in the shot. And, you know, nice picture. I had a lot of fun with them. They're just really nice, great people. All good. And so nice, 40 years with them. And they enjoyed the embassy suites and the whole thing. Doug, you're going to be signing autographs. Oh, absolutely. Let's see, another scam text. Hey, I hope everything is going great for you. Let's catch up soon. No, it's going terrible. Took the shot when I did an evening walk. The clouds look like a bunch of spaceships kind of floating up there. Reminded me a little bit of like Independence Day. Just nice shot. So just sharing some of the shots with you. Let's see, another scam text. Jack space comma space, let me show you a photo from my recent trip. God, these scammers suck. And this one I got from Danny. Me and my homies watching the eclipse. And what's the joke here? They're all staring at a Mitsubishi eclipse. That is really, really funny. Samarana gives me a big Alfred. I'm gonna give you a gong back there. There's the gong. Hello. We got a nice crowd here tonight. What else I got? Shot Amin Aziz at the mosque. When I stand next to Aziz, I realize how short I am or how tall he is. But yeah, it was really very, very good. And Aziz got a good picture of the eclipse, not the Mitsubishi. All right, so that's a good picture. Some people are saying, Alfred, you want to look at the eclipse? I'm like, yeah. Do you really think I trust the dollar store dog shit glasses? No. No, I'm not going to watch it. I also had read that some of the glasses were recalled. I don't know. Did you get a recalled pair? You definitely don't want to, you know, burn out your eye. What's up, Frankie Provolone? Zala says, the alien cloud shot would be a great desktop background. Yes. Yeah, Danny, that meme was good. I was actually making the joke before even seeing the meme. User not found. Imagine if Alpha was bald but had a black mustache and goatee. I am bald. This is a rug. It looks pretty good though. I paid a lot of money for it. Vin says I have to vlog the Retro Computer Club, but I don't know if they'll be too keen on that. You know, Chris, I stared directly at it. Mackie says the ISO certified glasses are safe. Okay, so please, what's the proper acronym for ISO? And then let's reverse engineer it, please. Very important. I want to see what Gasper comes up with. I'm good, Cineramic. I'm not bald. Come on. You saw the head of hair from 1984 when I was doing the Leaser demo. So that's why I still got it. It's all good. Muck says it's internet sex object. You got to start with what it really means. What is ISO? I'm sure it's International Standards Organization. Liam went with International Sex Organization. Danny went with Inbred Sister Orgy. Oh my effing God, Danny. Your mind's in the gutter. It's like everyone watching this broadcast. Mackie went with International Salt Organization? Mackie, I'm sorry. That's a little weak. You only changed one word? What do you mean salt? Whatever. Shit. Anyway, you know, one of the things that we haven't done, you're so offended. Yeah, I did encourage you. Correct. But you got to be good ones. And by the way, make sure you thumbs down or thumbs up. I don't care. Either way, I'd prefer thumbs down. We got to really stimulate that algorithm. An anal probe. Got to keep the family trees. Gotta keep the family tree a wreath. There you go. Zach, what does ISO stand for? I shit openly. That's good. Zach, that's so good. Zach, you're getting tonight's creative curse. Get your screenshots ready. All right. Zach, you get a creative curse on that one. I'm making a random flip on the left side and a random flip on the right side. Wow. Here you go, Zach. Here's your creative curse right from the book. You got... See if I can... Yeah. You got... You got the gyna clot, all right? So there is tonight's creative curse. And if you missed it earlier, tonight's non-sponsor is the... Tree Farm Balsam Fir Scented Soap so your rectum can smell like a Christmas tree. Rectum? Come on, Gasper. Damn near killed him. It was so bad. Listen, you know, a segment that we haven't done in a long time. Humble Wolf says that would be the perfect natter for porn videos for blind people. With the sound effects. Yes. All right. He says your aunt's name is Gina. Okay. A segment that we haven't done in a long time is the food porn segment. And I did queue up a couple of pictures. Let's switch to a preview and then let me press some buttons here. Let's of course fade in slowly. And let's, here we go. So this is my Thanksgiving. Sometime I'll call it Skanksgiving. It was hosted by my very good friends and neighbors, Jason and Deanna, and such nice detail right down to, like, you know, the place card setting. And this was like one Juan of three plates. I love the fact that they have the traditional salt and pepper shakers. Very, very nice detail on the table. Listen, I chowed down pretty damn good on Thanksgiving. This was posted by the Klingon princess Ava on her birthday. She had a cupcake. I said, since when do Klingons eat cupcakes? And her response was, the retort was, well, Worf enjoys some human food, like he likes prune juice. So following with Ava, here's Ava's a Klingon pizza. Looks very good. And I don't know if showing y'all at almost 10:30 at night the food stuff, it's kind of making me hungry. What can I say? So I'm sorry. Another one from Ava. I guess it's alphabetical. Maybe not. This is her New Year's Eve or New Year's Day meal. I guess, yeah. New Year, let's eat healthy. I don't know what the hell it is on the left-hand side, but it's a bunch of vegetables, which typically I say vegetables are decorative. Tanner posts a lot in the food set. I really got to start posting food, but I'm pretty boring because I'm like cooking like basic stuff in an air fryer. But yeah, this is from Tanner. His caption in the food segment was in the food prawn section of the Discord servers was like, why does this sandwich have three meats? But wow, that is yeah, Chris, you're hungry now. This is a beautiful sandwich. I mean, that is like a work of art. Come on, that is like a work of art. Yeah, sorry, Cineramic, making your stomach get excited there. Munchies, yes. Zala says, is that gah? It's a Klingon thing. Dan, I don't think it was a blunt in the cupcake. Gastro went with Spanksgiving. Yeah, right. Alpha, what do you think of the Chick-fil-A girl? Don't know the reference. Zach says, I think my girlfriend and I were talking about processed vaginas, and now Gina Klot on this is gold. Oh, goodness. All right, what's next in the food segment here? Tanner again. Tanner with this is like an artisan meal. We have a dead chicken embryo on there, but just the way, very, very decorative. Very nice, Tanner. You must have went to a fancy restaurant. This is another one from Tanner. He eats well, this boy. That is a beautiful pancake. Holy shit. Look at that. Let's zoom. Nice photography work. Were you using your phone, or were you using like your $9,000 Sony camera? Like, what are you using, Tanner, to take your food shots? What are you using? I'm curious. Yes, it does look like magazine quality. Listen, he's a professional photographer, so pictures look good. Let's see, Mac Geek, he slaughtered some farm animals, dead cow flesh. I mean, it is what it is. It is what it is. Looks good. Another one from Mac Geek. His caption here was like, you know, apples, they're healthy, right? That is a nice slice of pie. I'm not going to lie. Okay, so Tanner was using his Sony A7 III. He's using a high-end camera. 35mm, 1.4 lens. Nice. So there's the pie, and we got one more from Mac Geek. So this was the Pac-Man egg breakfast. Very well done. Listen, you all did a great job. You inspired me, even if it's my boring healthy meals, to start posting more in the food prawn section. And please, if you're not a member of our Discord server, we call it Pisscord, someone post the link, please. I don't know, I might have it somewhere in this piece of shit. Let me press buttons and resize windows so I can get to bit.ly and let's pull up Discord. Where the hell is it? Search Discord. Come on, someone beat me to the punch on this one. Copy, paste. And there it is. There's the official link for the Alpha.TV Discord server. I am not. If you're not a member, join it. We have a nice group of people. It's a lot of tech stuff and nonsense and blah, blah, blah. Okay. Did I short? No. Anyway. What else I got for you? Got some video clips queued up. I'm going to press some buttons, so bear with me a moment. Where the hell is it? I lost the videos. They are somewhere. And then we're going to get Vin on the phone, and then Danny on the phone, and then we'll wrap this crap up. Okay. All right, we're going to switch to L Media Player. What's up, Jack? All right, let's see if I can get to the L Media Video Player. So I'm playing a video that was upscaled. This I had posted on my iAlfred34 YouTube channel. This video has over 1 million views. The video is titled, Windows 7 on Apple Lisa. And, it got so many views and it was really funny. Like people giving me shit. Oh, F you, and other people responding back. Come on. Did you really think that Windows 7 was going to run on a machine from 1983 with a Motorola processor? Give me a break. So it was a lot of infighting, which is pretty damn funny. But here is the clip that was upscaled using that M1 iMac.
And the question is, do any of the viewers watching this iAlfred34 video find this interesting or even just amusing? Did you chuckle seeing the box of Windows 7 Ultimate on top of a 25-year-old Apple Lisa system? Let me know. Whatever.
And so the fact that that video got over 1 million views just goes to show you that people like watching crap. All right. So it was time to give the trash can a blowjob. Long overdue.
Oh, it was time to give the Mac Pro a blowjob, and my oh my, lots of dirt indeed did blow out of this system. Oh, you dirty little girl, you.
So the deal with that was that the fan was running at about like almost 2,000, almost full blast, and it was time to give that clean that thing out. Now the fan speed is running a lot lower and the machine is running a lot better. So there you go. All right. So I did film one short little clip. It was dirty, Tanner. Yes, I did it in the shower. Absolutely. All right. So here we go. Clip with Dave and Deb and Dave Sr.
Well, I'm here with Deb and Dave.
Hi.
Deb and Dave Sr., who's sitting down. We'll get him in the frame in a second. But we had a nice congratulations on your 40th anniversary.
Thank you.
And how come David didn't come down?
We tried.
Yeah, Dave, I'm going to rip you a new butthole verbally.
David, I told Alfred you're going to get down here and see him.
Yes. Yeah, so
you have to, because you got to see the condo. It looks totally different.
Yeah, and tell your father to get rid of that freaking Android piece of shit phone. Gonna bust his balls on that one. Come on, Dave, look at the camera. Nice. Happy anniversary.
Thank you very much. Amazing meal. Thank you.
Yes, thank you very much.
You didn't have to do that. Thank you.
You're welcome. Let's get ice cream now. Just kidding.
So Dave Sr. is on an Android phone. It just screws up all the group texts, but whatever. And oh, hi, Mark says, yeah, the Mac Pro puts the fans in OnlyFans, correct? anyway, the next clip, another upscaled retro clip. This was the booting the Lisa with no mouse. And I'll tell you, my Toby, who is our VP of finance at my ad agency, she did such a great job with the acting and the scream. I just watched this clip, and it's so great, and the upscale is really good. So here you go, booting a Lisa with no mouse. You get a little bit of a pan shot in my office.
By the way, I did frame that Apple III poster I found that was featured in the Tomb video. Check out how nice it came out. It looks really good. So I framed it with a UV glass, so it is hanging up in front of my office. Actually, it's hanging up on top of the Windows XP system, and I got an old stinky iMac over there. And I got another Windows system over here, and an X Cube, and there she is, the Lisa without a mouse. I know all you guys have been dying to see this thing boot up, or to see if it even boots up, or to see if it blows up in my face. I know you've been waiting for that. I don't have the mouse, all right? But you know what? I mean, what the hell could possibly happen? I'm going to try to boot this thing without the mouse. So, you know, let's give it a try. Let's see what happens. Here we go. The Lisa system being booted without the mouse. 3, 3, 2, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1.
Danger. The emergency disruption system is now activated.
Oh, shit.
The ship will detonate in T-minus
oh my God.
10 minutes. The option to override automatic detonation expires in T-minus 5 minutes. Emergency disrupt system is now activated. The ship will detonate in T-minus 10 minutes. The option to override automatic detonation.
And, yeah, a lot of fun. Obviously, you remember the audio clip from the first Alien movie, which is actually being released in the theaters again. So this is something I upscaled just recently. This is actually the very first broadcast stream on Ustream. This was on March 8th, 2006. And this was like, you know, what I pulled down from the Ustream server, which I don't know what the hell format they recorded in. It was bizarre, but the upscale came out pretty good. So here you go. Here's the first, it's short, the first ever live stream. Roll it.
Okay, I'm doing a quick Ustream video test. And yes, that's like laundry hanging on the back, but it's clean. Whatever. You know what I'm doing this on? Am I using the 4-core whore? No. Am I using the FF class Mac Pro 17-inch laptop with the 2.6 gigahertz processor, 4 gigs of RAM, and the high-def built-in video camera? No. I'm using the ratty old, stinky old, heavily upgraded, grossly upgraded, spent way too much money upgraded G4. It gets a whatever. See you soon.
Wow, the beachside condo is so dark during the eclipse. Then again, this is actually the way it always looks, with the color scheme of dark gray with extra dark trim. Yes, absolutely no difference. Nice.
Yeah, so yeah, the joke there, the condo is always dark. That's my color scheme. But listen, so the eyes are a little whatever, but overall, I mean, I think considering what the source material looked like,
I found some.
Well,
I can show them. You ask again.
No, shut up, Siri. The source material was pretty ratty, so it is what it is. From Boca's Krypton, whatever. All right, so one more clip, and Danny, this is the clip of your brother. I'm going to play it, then we can talk about it later, because Danny's brother Nick was being interviewed by a magazine or whatever. He'll talk about it. Let's roll the clip.
I know people that I would have never normally run into or cross paths with if it weren't for Cars or Low Riders. And, you know, it's a family out here, man. It's what Kansas City does. Not a lot of people know that we got a scene out here, and it's a tight one.
So Danny's brother is being interviewed by Low Rider. Kind of cool. So those are the photo and video clips I wanted to share with you all. And at this point, I think, Vinny, you want to get your Skype up, and you can give us the update on some of the some of the conspiracy theories and what's going on out there. So go ahead and Skype in, and we'll do an audio check. Yeah, Danny's brother was in a bad car accident, motorcycle accident. But yeah, it's good to see him getting around good. All right, so waiting for a Vin. By the way, is Ava in the house? Oh, we had Vin calling her. Let me press buttons. Vin, go ahead, give the testy 1, 2, 3.
Testies 1, 2, 3.
Okay, I think you're sounding good. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I am well. Thank you. So, the eclipse came and went.
Right.
CERN did their physics experiment. Give us the update. What's going on out there in the conspiracy and QAnon realms?
So, of course, as you know, we had, prior to the eclipse, we had the pre-show of the earthquake on Friday,
right,
which sparked a whole lot of conspiracy theories.
What were they concerned about? What was the problem? An earthquake? Okay.
Yeah. Well, I mean, it is in a weird spot for an earthquake on the East Coast. We usually don't get too many of those.
Right.
And it did cover quite a large surface area. Representative Marjorie Taylor Greene, who we all know and love, said on Twitter, she says, "God is sending America strong signs to tell us to repent. Earthquakes and eclipses and many more things to come. I pray that our country listens." This is all obviously batshit crazy. Mm. The eclipse is not, you know, this weather phenomenon. It's something that, you know, could be predicted back hundreds of years, you know, by doing math.
Right. Right. No, it was predicted. I mean, we knew this thing was coming. It's not a surprise eclipse.
Right. We predict these things hundreds of years into the future. It's just math. And by, you know, doing an equation of how the Earth and the Moon and the Sun and the positions, it's not random. It didn't catch us off guard. It's kind of just a thing that happens when planets rotate and move around like that.
Right.
The earthquake, a little more bizarre, but it could still be kind of explained by it does. Some people are saying that the earthquake had to do with the eclipse because of the gravitational pull from the moon and the tidal waves.
Yeah, but what about the gravitational pull from Lizzo?
That's still, it's,
you
still
factor that in too.
Yeah, I think the FBI is covering that up. But yeah, I mean, it's strange that it happens in the East Coast, but it does happen. And the reason that it covered such a large surface area, you know, it's a big part of the North, or most of the Northeast felt the earthquake. And that's because the rocks on the East Coast are different than the West Coast. When you get an earthquake on the West Coast, it's usually in a smaller area. But the way that the sediment is on the East Coast, it allows for a larger kind of shock.
I guess because of the solid rock, the resonance of the quake is going to disperse more through the more denser rocks.
Right.
It yeah. sounds good if I said it, you know, seriously, yes.
Right, yeah. Let's go with that. I mean, it's, you know.
Chris, rip Lizzo's career. Yeah, is she done now?
I think she got canceled, yeah.
Did she get canceled?
Yeah, there was this whole controversy about how she treated her staff like shit.
Oh, well, yeah, that I know. That's old news. Yeah, she was a little on the nasty side. And Drew yeah. Moody in the house. Drew Moody's wife is expecting a duty machine also. So the Moody's are going to have a duty machine.
Is it hers?
Huh?
Is it hers?
What do you mean, is it her? Who's the father? It's Drew.
No, I'm saying, no, I always love saying, like, who's the mother?
Oh, who's the mother? Right, you flip it around.
Yeah.
Then she, right, then she canceled herself. Humble Wolf said, I'm going to enter a batting cage and replace the baseballs with concrete balls. Okay. Be hard. Really hurt someone. Mr. Moody says, thank you. Well, it's ours. And yes, I put in the work for that baby.
There you go.
All right, good.
There you have it. You heard it here first.
Yes, you heard it. How about when P-Dog announced that his girlfriend was... But no, when the girlfriend did the pregnancy test live on air, yeah. That was nuts. That was some...
That was some quality content.
That was some quality Alfred.TV content back in the day.
We got to find him.
Yeah, we got to find him. He could be in the slam.
Yeah.
But maybe not.
Maybe we should just do some cold calls to the prisons.
But did you read anything about CERN and the nuclear physics, you know, the accelerator experiments at CERN that the Large Hadron Collider, did they work that in as like opening up, you know, gateways to hell or New Jersey or something like that?
No, I didn't hear about CERN. I heard they're taking a very, you know, biblical approach to it, that God is mad about Joe Biden. And
really?
So he sent a tiny little earthquake to New Jersey kind of thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and then an eclipse. Yeah, I mean, it's very far-fetched. Then you also have people that are saying that the eclipse was a massive cover-up for a large-scale human sacrifice.
Oh, geez. Really? What, right. to take the attention away from a... Okay.
Right. So I guess while it was dark out for a few minutes, they were able to cover up a large-scale human sacrifice.
Yeah, I was watching some of the YouTube videos... that, you know, they're mostly clickbait, preying on, you know, preying, P-R-E-Y on people.
Right.
And they're talking about, you know, during the eclipse, you know, to bring wealth and happiness. And they're referencing putting talismans in your bedroom and cleansing the whatever and the energy. And I'm like, talismans? And these people are saying, you know, praise the Lord Jesus. It's like witchcraft. You're using talismans? Like, I wanted to respond to some people. Are you that feeble-minded? Really?
Right.
You know, you're going to orange peels and you're going to you should dust your bedroom for God's sakes, you know. Yeah. It's really crazy. It really did rattle up some of the weak minded without any doubt. It really did. I just imagine, like I said, you know, people, you know, listen, I've heard everything from banks are failing and it's just crazy. But all right. So we survive another day.
Right.
And there, listen, you want to believe in God? God, yeah, I'm sure he's angry. The whole planet needs an enema. That's what I say.
Right.
And I'm quoting that Batman movie from the 90s where the Joker said, Jack Nicholson, this whole town needs an enema. He was referencing Gotham City, but the whole planet needs an enema, you know?
Yeah.
It does. So it's just a freaking mess. And that's why we're taking a break from reality and watching this crap, my show, on YouTube, you know?
Right.
and the glasses were a psyop, so he had to stare directly into the eclipse, right? Christ. Anything else, Finn, you want to add on to the what's going on?
Yeah, there was another one. Let's see. There was one I have here. It says that the eclipse has to do with Kate Middleton.
Really?
It has. As you know, she just recently announced her cancer diagnosis after being gone missing for a month.
Right. She's taking treatment now, isn't she?
Yeah. So people are kind of saying, you know, that Kate Middleton. So this one you need to do a lot of mental gymnastics on. So it's Kate Middleton and King Charles. They both got cancer at around the same time. So people are thinking that the Russians poisoned them at the same time, right? And the eclipse is some sort of like cover up, or, you know, it ties back into the human sacrifice too. They had to cover up something. I forget what it was. I'm looking for where I wrote it down. But it's insane the way that they tie all of these events together.
Well, listen, you need to get a message to them and inform them that if they take horse-grade ivermectin, it should resolve the cancer problem, you know?
I think that's right, yeah.
I just, you know, people are on this ivermectin kick still, which I find it baffling. Peter in the house, what's up, Peter? Yeah, you missed Woz.
Yeah, Woz was just here. It was a great segment.
My nephew-in-law, Chris, with a K, says, yep, it was her portal to Princess Diana.
Oh, right. Oh, like sort of like in Star Wars where they have the ghosts and they can speak to them that way.
Whatever.
This is good.
Well, listen, I hope Kate gets the treatment that she needs and they can get that under control.
I hope she tells Princess Diana about Alfred.TV live on Wednesday nights now. Yeah. Maybe she's still tuning in on Thursdays.
Have you been trying to get a hold of the QAnon queen?
I need to get back. I tried for a while and then I got booted from her Telegram server.
Really?
Yeah, I got kicked out of the Telegram group, so I got to find a way to get back in there.
Just make a new account. Did they ever acknowledge you? I mean, we want her on the show. We want to hear what she has to say.
Right. I feel like we need to put together some kind of like a demo reel, just like make some fake clips of you put like saying conspiracy things, and then we'll send her the demo reel and be like, yeah, Alfred is really open-minded about, you know, the conspiracies and stuff.
Chris, I put ivermectin on my eyes during the eclipse.
Yeah, I think you should, or after. You have to look at the eclipse. You have to stare at the eclipse without blinking for 5 seconds.
Yeah. No, you don't. Don't do that. You never stare at an eclipse. I don't trust those glasses. I'm sorry. Peter says, how do we know the shore of the Earth is round? I don't know. Seasons? That's a good one. Time zone? You know, there's a couple of simple explanations.
Speaking of not trusting the glasses, a large amount of those glasses got recalled.
Yes. Yes. Who the F is going to trust those things? Get out of here. Like I said, there were some neighbors out. Alfred, you want to see the eclipse? I'm like, no. No, I had 2 freaking retina tears. I'm thankful for the vision that I have and was corrected with laser surgery. Am I going to look at the eclipse? Nay, nay. And yes, you got to L your hardware vendor for support. I really might make those T-shirts.
Yeah, those would be good. Yeah, some guy was drop shipping like some cheap some like cheap ones from China. And
wait, did you just say China?
China.
You put China. An R at the end. That was pretty creative. And Drew, you keep on annoying me with it. What am I looking at my text message for? What'd you get? You got a new car? You got a new 2010 Chevy Suburban? Who cares? You got a baby on the way. This is all irrelevant now. You got a baby on the way. Who gives a shit about your new SUV? It's all about the. It's all about the baby.
the car.
He sent me a picture of the car. You got a baby on the way. This is. It's all. Listen, arts and crafts are over. Fun and games are over, Big Daddy.
Oh, no.
But listen, I guess it's going to be a good, safe car when you have the little duty machine strapped in. So that's good.
Yeah.
Oh, the Klingon princess is here. Ava, you were featured in the food segment of some of your delicacies, those Klingon delicacies. But I got to give the shout out.
Welcome to Station WFCK. The only thing missing is you.
There we go. Klingon princess in the house. Andrew says she's a gas-guzzling bitch. She shouldn't refer to your wife. Oh, you mean the car. Okay, I wasn't sure. We're talking about your wife, and then I'm reading gas-guzzling bitch. Zach said, anyone hear that Lunchables have lead in them?
Oh, yeah, that's something that happened. They got banned from schools because of high... I guess there was, like, some school somewhere that was serving Lunchables. And they stopped because they found large amounts of lead. I mean, we all knew that stuff was shit. It was for lazy parents.
Oh, shit. Lead in the Lunchables. Listen, all the processed food is not, as you all know, is not good.
Right.
You got to cook stuff and get stuff fresh and you know, eating processed crap. What do you expect?
Yeah. I used to love that.
Oh, my brother Gary's here. Oh, we were just getting an update on conspiracy theories. And what is the current leading one right now? What's the word out there?
Well, now that nothing happened after the eclipse.
Right, nothing happened.
Going back to COVID, actually, Robert Kennedy Jr. was on News Nation on Monday.
Right. And, not JFK Jr., Robert Kennedy.
RFK Jr.
Right, RFK Jr. Has JFK Jr. been around? Isn't he supposed to be running with Trump?
Yeah, I guess so.
Right, okay.
But no, RFK Jr. is running his own independent campaign, right. And he just went on to Cuomo's new show and said that our whole country has just had a big medical experiment for 3 years performed on them. Obviously talking about the COVID vaccines.
Right.
Still talking about that big right. experiment.
So I guess the experiment worked out good. How many people were vaccinated? About 180 million, 200 million?
Yeah, a lot of people.
200 million, and the conspiracy theory at the time was that everyone that got the shot was going to die within 1 to 2 years. Now, listen, planet's overpopulated as it is, so I'm all for it, but do we have a 50% reduction in population? Nay, nay. I guess
right.
overall, the vaccine, at 200 million vaccinations overall, the numbers are pretty good.
Yeah.
Right?
Right. I mean, we're not wearing masks anymore. We're kind of back to normal.
And to quote Emo Chris, the mRNA technology was developed years ago for the SARS virus. It wasn't rolled out because SARS burned itself out. And as you know, a virus is lock and key. So they took the mRNA technology, tweaked it for COVID-19, and did people that get the vaccination, did they still get COVID? Yes, but it drastically reduced the impact of the virus. That's right. The deal. So, yeah, so nothing happened, and now they're back on COVID-19. It gets a whatever. Yes, Peter, I've been getting the boosters. Not a problem. Not a problem. Muck says, I got all 9. And there was some guy that got like a couple of 100 boosters. Did you ever hear that?
Oh,
idiot.
My God.
Yeah, that was that.
Wasn't
was
he in our Discord? What was his name again?
Who? Muck. Muck says he got all 9 boosters.
Yeah. No. What was his name? I forget his name. Hypochondriac.
The hypochondriac? Oh, that works at the Apple store.
Yeah.
William.
Yeah.
He went to the hospital so many times, like they knew him, like you hear again. Like it was nuts.
Oh, boy.
Peter says, what's the vaccine brand of choice? Well, I checked with Emo Chris, the pharmacist, and he liked the Pfizer flavor. So that was, we use flavors. He liked Pfizer.
It depends on which company you have stock investments in.
Right. Dennis said, considering that the Stanley Cups have lead in them, I can see how they were a trend and how they affected the YouTube UI designers. Well, I think that the lead was at the bottom, but it was in an area that wasn't exposed to the fluids, right? Now, listen, everything's going to kill you. It's everything in moderation. Ava said, I wonder how many bloody noses William had lately. Yeah, listen, he only comes in here to bitch and complain. Maybe we'll call him one day live. We'll just call. I have his cell number somewhere. We'll just call him. Because we all want our Alfred.TV. We want his discount at the Apple store.
Is he still working there?
I think so. But he's a little bit of a prick. He goes in there with his Android phone. You know, and that can't be good. He said, I prefer the Clorox vaccine.
Yeah,
but whatever. Peter says, I wonder if anyone will still use a power PC as their main machine. I would say no. As their main, no, that chip technology is a little bit on the
maybe side. He means as their main machine, like they keep it up in the attic in the state of Maine.
Oh, okay.
Like when they have a...
It's a good way to twist the joke around.
Yeah, okay. They have a cabin up in Maine, and they have an old power PC kicking around there.
Yeah, you're really doing well with your bad jokes. It's yeah. Good. Dennis said he used to rock a PowerBook G4, maxed out until around 2018. Zach says, wait, Alfred, if you've gotten all your boosts, then your 5G service must be stellar. Right, they tied 5G in with the boosters and...
Wait.
My niece wants a shout out. All right. She's falling asleep. Here's a shout out, Chris, with a K. It's Get up.
How could you fall asleep to this content?
Yeah, how could you fall asleep? Yeah, this is premium content. Ava says there's some people in the low end Mac group who actually try daily a power PC who actually try to daily? I don't get it.
There's some people in the low end Mac group who actually try to daily drive a power PC machine.
I'm not sure what she saw, what she means there. Max Muck says, I saw the FF Class Dual G5 Power Mac on sale locally for $60. Such a deal. FF Class is quad, come on. I got two quad G5s. One was the 2.7 gigawatt water-cooled one that failed. The 2.5, I think, works. All right, daily use. All right.
That's got to be your next AI upscale video. Is the one where you're upgrading?
Oh, the G4.
No. The G5, and you're like trying to figure out how to put the RAM in, and it's like printed on the side panel of the thing.
Is that where I made the Rosie O'Donnell joke? What was the joke?
Hotter than the ball bearings on the treadmill that's run on by Rosie O'Donnell.
Yeah, that was good. I made that one up on the fly. Unbelievable.
You also, when you're talking about the riser card, you're talking about the Paul Reiser card.
Paul Reiser, right, the actor.
Yeah.
oh, geez. All in good fun. Well, listen, I got to queue up Danny Minnick next, Vin. I appreciate the update on conspiracy nonsense. Yes, nothing happened. End of the world. I was running around anywhere I went outside. It's the end of the world. What are you doing? People just laughing. Yeah. But it was really funny with the gal at Ace Hardware. Yeah, people are going nuts to stock it up on stuff. I'm like, what? It's the end of the world. What are you going to stock up on?
Yeah.
if the world is ending, what are you running out and buying?
I'm not paying for anything.
But, okay, good. Maybe get a new Corvette.
Yeah, I'll go shoplifting.
Yeah, correct. Yes, looting. Well, they do that in California now. It's like normal scrotocol.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever. All right, anyway, Vin, I appreciate you doing your research and calling in on this fine, outstanding live webcast. I'm going to queue up Mr. Minnick, and then I'm going to shortly thereafter go to bed because I'm freaking tired. I've been up since 6 a.m. Mm-hmm. Right, and Mac Geek, here you... What end of the world? What are you stocking up on? Toilet paper and Spam. There you go.
Yeah, there you go.
I think that's work. I think that would work. Yes, and so you can eat the Spam and shit it out and wipe your ass and all good. All right, Vin, thank you. I will talk to you again. And yes. Danny, get your Skype up. I'll talk to you later, man. Bye bye. The great Vin Doria. Ron Knights, are you still here and you still alive? As we say hello, give a shout out to the great Ron Knights. Danny, you're gonna call. You gonna Skype in or just shit? I think I just closed Skype. All right, I was just rating that as a 5-star call. Unbelievable, folks. All right, Danny, I just hung up on. Sam says, when was the last time you used a PowerPC Mac? Last time I used a PowerPC Mac. It's been a while, Sam. Wow, Danny inbound. Daniel? Danny? This is a tech fail. I can't hear you. Testy 1, 2, 3. Come on, Dan. You're calling in on the tech segment, but you're having a technical failure. Jesus H. Christos. No, Muck. You missed Waz. Yeah, what was a movie that... Vin, what was a movie you ran last week? Danny, I can't hear you, so I'm gonna hang up on you. Call back. Yes. Wow, I just realized that the stream deck is not working. I just noticed that it's not even running. I gotta figure that one out. Oh, you watched the movie Predator. Was that about Diddy or Harvey Weinstein? Or the one from the Alien Yeah, stock joke. Yeah, it's a good movie though. And Danny did not work. So I think Danny is going to try to fix his audio. And the interim will continue. Let me look at my notes. Yes, I actually make notes for this garbage. Oh, your Skype froze? All right, so yeah, Alien's a great film. And I see the hearts here. Make sure you hit thumbs up or thumbs down, please. Very important. Danny, you want to give it another try? All right, Danny's trying again. Let's see. Hello. Dan, I can't hear you. You gotta get your inputs right. I guess. Dan, wait, I can hear sound.
How about now?
I can hear you now.
Okay. All right.
I can hear you with bass in your voice. We were very concerned that you were gonna come off as a soy boy with the bass not there. But I can hear you. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good. So that video clip of Nick, he's going to be on a TV show called Lowrider?
No, I think they were... He just went on their Instagram page.
Well, I think that's pretty cool, though, still.
Yeah.
Yeah, and what is Lowrider? Is that by a urologist talks about low-hanging testicles, or is it a car show?
Car show.
Okay, I wasn't sure. Nick is your... Older brother or younger brother? I don't even know.
Younger. I'm the oldest.
Okay, so he's the younger, slightly cooler brother. He's well, you're a car guy too, so.
Yeah, but he likes the old schools. I like the new stuff, you know.
Okay, right. So what's he driving around now?
He drives a '96 Impala SS, all black.
Okay, and is the SS? We have a little bit of extra horsepower in there.
Yeah.
By the way, I was thinking of you because I saw a clip on YouTube. Some guy had a Corvette Z06, and all he did was like blast by police officers, like on purpose. They finally got him.
Oh no!
They finally got it, but like, and he would film. He had a GoPro camera mounted in the back of the car, and like a couple of GoPros mounted to get like the full scene. And in other words, he'd be cruising normal speed. He'd see a police officer on the freeway, and then he'd nail it, and you know, and he escapes. Many times, but they finally got him. He was in a black Z06. I don't know if it was a C7 series or a C8. The C8 Z06 is relatively new, correct?
Yeah.
That just came out. So he was in one of them, but he was definitely in a Z06, and he was definitely driving at some pretty speeds. But like I said, he would light it up with the flames coming out of the back and the whole bit. And just egg on the cops. I mean, what balls,
right?
And I think I don't know if he had a record or whatever. But they finally got him. I'm like, oh my god! I was looking at some of the clips on YouTube, and it was really something. Did I send you that video of the guy that had the Corvette that was evading police as well in L.A.? And he drove into the city, and I don't know if they ever caught him.
I don't know if they did or not.
He went into like a dense city area, into like a multi-level parking. I think he maybe dumped the car.
I'm subscribed to KTLA on YouTube because they have police chases about every day now.
Okay.
And they always go live, and it's usually while I'm at work, so I'll have it on while I'm working at the computer. And it's so entertaining.
Yeah, it's good entertainment. What blows my mind though still is when you see people getting pulled over And the police officer asks, can I see your ID? And they, who doesn't carry ID with them? I don't get it. It's weird.
I've always got mine.
Of course. You're supposed to. It's standard scrotocol again for driving around. You're supposed to have ID on you, for God's sake. Yeah. Even if you get hurt, you know.
If I don't have ID on me, that means I don't have my wallet on me, which means I left it at home on accident, you know?
Right. Right. And you know, all your Bitcoin is
right.
God knows where that is.
Speaking of.
What?
So I cashed all my Bitcoin out when it fell, 2 years ago, I think?
Yes.
So there's like 20 cents in there.
Oh, God. What's your 20 cents worth now?
It went up, obviously. It's up to 70,000 now, you know? And I opened mine yesterday and I had $25 in there.
Again, you were the big winner.
Yeah. So I cashed it out and got dinner, you know?
You've done the best out of any investment ever. What was it? $1 in Bitcoin you bought and it went up to 100?
50 cents the first time. This is 50 cents. This is 2017. 50 cents. I left it in there for a year because I kind of forgot about it. Opened up the app and it was $150.
Damn.
Yeah.
Damn. Did it
again recently from 20 cents to $25. It's wild.
I don't have Bitcoin. I have Ethereum and something else. I put in 1,000. It went up to 1,500. Dropped down to 200. Now it's like at 800 or 900. I don't know. Is Bitcoin stable or is it going on the slide again?
I checked today. It's almost 71,000.
Imagine that. And what was it down to a few years ago? 20?
Yeah.
Listen, who knew? It's a commodity. It's a very high risk.
Yeah.
Yeah. Very high risk. I really got to come out with Alcoin. I'm sure we can, you know, I'd say so many grifters out there on YouTube.
Oh my goodness.
It's really disgusting. You know,
it really is. Like Logan Paul's made so much money off of ripping everybody else off.
Is he going to be fighting, what's his face?
Mike Tyson.
When?
And, I think it's in May, I think.
What happens when Mike Tyson like could potentially really hurt him?
That's what I'm hoping for.
Really?
Oh yeah. I want this dude breathing out of a straw when Mike's done with him. I am not a Logan Paul fan. I'm not a Paul fan.
I'm just saying from a human and personal say, you don't want to see someone really get damaged. But I guess he's pretty much a wise. See, one factor he doesn't know about Tyson. Tyson's an animal.
I know. He ripped a guy's ear off.
Yeah, he bit it.
Oh yeah, bit a guy's ear off. But yeah, I remember. After, like, seeing the footage after he did that, and the cops are like scared to approach him because they had to arrest him. Sure. You know? Yeah.
I guess if Mike was with Diddy, I guess he would just gently nibble his ear.
Oh no.
I'm kind of done with all the Diddy shit. You know, it's all clickbait. It's all allegations, clickbait, and I don't know. Well, see, someone's gonna get paid off.
Law and Crime Network on YouTube is having a field day. There's like 6 videos a day on Diddy.
Yes, correct.
And at this point, I'm like, yeah, they're milking it. I get it. I don't blame them. They're making money. But also, I'm ready for them to go ahead and arrest him now. We all know he's guilty. He's going to be the next R. Kelly.
Yeah, it's true. Chris says, apparently Tyson doesn't receive any money if he knocks Jake Paul out. So I get, okay, so they want to keep.
Fixed.
Does that mean?
That means it's fixed.
No, that means that they want duration. Listen, you know, I always say when you have the Super Bowl and they go into extra innings, I'm making a joke. When they go into overtime,
yeah.
I say, they did it for the advertisers, you know? Am I right? And
I can see that, definitely.
And Lo-Fi says the fight is July 20th, Jake Paul versus Mike Tyson. Thank you, Lo-Fi.
Okay.
You know, and the joke was back, you know, my mother used to scream and yell constantly, and my father tried to always calm her down, but I remember visiting my father, this is in what, in late 90s or early, yeah, late 90s probably.
Yeah.
And there was a big Mike Tyson fight on that night, and I said, hey, Dad, who do you think is going to win the fight tonight? And his response was, probably your mother again. Which was great. The Klingon princess, it's time for her to go. Heading to the orifice tomorrow morning, so I actually have to go to bed at a decent time. Well, to the Klingon princess, I did show your cupcake that you had, and I did share the comment that Worf likes prune juice. I assume you like prune juice as well, so I'll say kapla in Klingonese, and enjoy your dreams, and have a pleasant day at work. Klingon princess, signing out. Is Gaspar still here, and has he been flatulating regularly? I must ask. Vin says, what's the cover? What's the over under on Paul? Maybe I'll put 50 cents on Paul winning.
If Mike's really not allowed to, if he's not going to get paid, if he knocks Jake Paul out, I feel like it's probably going to be another scripted tie.
Yeah, that's disappointing to hear. There was one YouTuber that did some reaction video. They were looking at Mike's training videos, and in one video, Mike Tyson's wearing these cute white shorts, and he freeze frames it and says, Mike, no on the shorts. No, a little too cute.
But his training videos where he's boxing with his, you know, with his trainer, I'm like, dude,
he's fast.
He's I don't know how old he is, but he's not young anymore. He's not a kid.
No,
but he's scary. I'm like, that's why I was like, man.
Though I will
Logan's gonna get killed. That's what I was thinking, but maybe not.
The first time, though, I heard Mike Tyson speak, I was fell out of my chair. I was laughing. Yeah.
Doesn't have an intimidating voice, no, but his punches, man.
Yeah, you're right. The voice is not intimidating.
It doesn't match the body at all.
The slight speech disorder or lisp or whatever the fuck he got. Tanner says Mike's training with a legit coach.
Yeah. Nice. And I don't know. I guess Jake Paul's training with his boys, his yes men. I don't know.
I don't know. He should have David DeFranco as his trainer. David, toughen him up. Yeah, Dave said he's going to call. He wants to be a guest on the show.
Senior or junior?
Junior.
Oh, that'd be cool.
Yes. And what's the first thing I'm going to say when he calls in? Why the fuck didn't you come down?
Right.
And celebrate the anniversary with your family?
Oh, I'd have gone. I would have gone.
We went to a nice fat fuck Italian restaurant. Danny, did I take you to that restaurant when you visited?
We went to a Cuban restaurant that I can't get over 2 years later.
Yeah,
it was that good.
Yeah, you had that hunk of fish.
Yeah.
Like with the head on it.
As I ate it.
Yeah. Aziz joined us that night too, didn't he?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. So we got a couple of birthdays coming up. We got my brother Gary's birthday. We got tax day on the 15th. We got my brother's birthday on the 16th. Aziz's birthday on the 17th. Yeah, I might not be able to do the show on Wednesday. I might be going out and eating with a bunch of people for a birthday celebration. Sam says that's the reason Mike fights, to manage the anger because of his voice. Sam, that was good. Very good. Vin went to Little Havana as well. Little Havana is good. Yes. But there's an Italian joint. It's not a joint. It's like a nice restaurant called Luigi de Roma across the street. And that's another nice... When Gary comes down with his lovely wife, we're gonna go there for their anniversary meal. So it's good eats. What can I say? And listen, you know, Danny, when I'm not eating out, I'm pretty strict and exercising. Yep. It lets me indulge when I eat out. And, right. And let me tell you something. The Italian bakery stuff I picked up for my friend's wife's birthday, I ate it.
Oh, I bet.
11:30 at night. You know, he even dusted off the Nespresso, the high class coffee machine. Holy shit! I see my niece, Alexa. She has a good scam. When she has company over, the Nespresso machine gets hidden, and the freaking Keurig machine gets pulled out.
Right. Yeah. I don't blame her.
That's freaking funny. Yeah, keep the Nespresso on the down low. Those effing pods are expensive. But yeah, Pho Ocean's good too. Yeah, that's the did we go to Pho, the Vietnamese place?
No, we didn't.
No, I took you to your first Jewish deli though.
Yeah, we did go there.
What an experience, right?
That was amazing too.
Yeah, that was
it was a car show walking in.
Yeah.
And walking out.
Chris is just one hitting you hooked. What, from the Nespresso? Listen, Chris, is she still hiding the Nespresso when you got company over? Oh, and by the way, Vin's asking, are you going to try to save up some shekels for Halloween Horror Night?
Yes. I would like to, because my birthday's on the 30th.
Okay. Yeah, that would be fun.
So that would be cool to spend it in Florida.
Oh, and Chris, you're the one that started her on the espresso. Okay, and your mother-in-law, my sister, Deb, when I was shoplifting at Target with her, that was an impulse buy. I got to restock the cups. Where do you buy, not the ball sack, the what do you call them?
The K-cups?
You don't call them K-cups, Nespresso cups. What do you call them? They're those domes. It uses its own shit.
I guess it wouldn't be called K. That's a competitor.
Yeah, right. It wouldn't be called K.
Yeah.
Well, Nespresso is an N, so you call it an N cup.
Oh, pods.
Oh, the pods.
What? Tide pods?
My brother asked, what was the dish of food you got at that Italian restaurant? What I got when for Dave and Deb's anniversary, they had a special on swordfish, which I like. So I got the swordfish, but I got it with the rigatoni, and we did the normal start, Gary. Two orders of the two meatballs with the oil slick for dipping and the marinara sauce for dipping. Listen, we're talking food now. It's what, 11:18? We're even getting hungry now.
Sounds good. I've never had swordfish, but it sounds like it'd be good.
Yeah, it's good. A Tide Pod is my go-to flavor.
Same flank.
Tannis is N cubs. That's a big set of boobs. Damn. Where else did we go to eat, though, Danny? We didn't just go to the Jewish deli. We were down here for 9 days.
Right. We had a lot of food at home.
Breakfast? I was trying to help you because you were dealing with the sugar problem.
Right.
Right. I was doing a lot of cooking with the air fryer and stuff at home. Correct. We went to First Watch, didn't we?
Yeah. And I was like, hey, we have those in Kansas City.
You do?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. First Watch is good.
Yep.
Yeah,
I got the oatmeal. That was good.
Right. Okay.
And we also went to that donut place.
Vin, tell Danny the donut that you had a dandy donut. I was having like minor chest pains while he was eating this. It was really bizarre. It was like a bacon laced. It was a bacon donut. Don't go ooh. It's disgusting.
I've had them before.
A crispy pig flesh on a donut.
They're pretty good because you get the sweet and savory.
Yeah,
the maple bacon donut. Yes.
Yeah, sweet and savory.
Yep. So,
but Gary, when you and Karen come down, I know Karen's going to want that special. It was Karen had a Fra Diavolo fish, shrimp, lobster, huge. She got like two or three meals out of it, which was pretty good. Nabil in the house. How are you, Nabil?
So I will say, we have a chain up here, kind of like Wawa, but it's called Quick Trip.
Wait a second. If you mentioned a chain. Shit, I blew the joke. What was the name of the artist that was chaining people in his basement?
R. Kelly.
Yeah. Okay. There's an R. Kelly joke in there somewhere. How about those other, that kid that went to the neighbor that escaped, the two nut jobs?
Did you watch the video on YouTube?
Holy crap.
It's from Law and Crime. I mean, these people are making so much money off of criminals.
Yeah, showing how to properly parent and discipline your child. They had the kids duct taped together.
They were like some weird Mormon cult or something like that.
I don't know, but at least they, listen, thank God that kid was smart enough to get out of the house, and that elderly neighbor, what's the matter, son? He assessed that he needed help. Guy was almost in tears.
But Tanner, I have some bad news about that. There's a chain here called Come and Go. Bad news about that chain. It was recently bought. They're changing the name. The new owners think the original name is too immature, is what they're saying.
Oh, see, they're going to blow the brakes. See, that's dumb.
Now, it is dumb.
Now I'm going to speak as a 35-year marketing executive, okay?
Yeah.
They're buying the brand name. They're going to throw the brand name out? That's stupid.
Yep.
That's
dumb.
There's
a lot of people not happy.
No, they got bad move.
Right.
So who's the marketing director at the company that they're working for? Is it the same gal that hired Mulvaney for Budweiser, Bud Light, whatever the hell it was?
So out of touch, but Sam, might as well been.
Sam said, if the coffee is French, it's called Le Bol Cups.
So, okay, I pulled up the article. They're going to... So the chain that bought Come and Go is called Maverick, and they're gonna rename all the Come and Goes to Maverick.
Wow, you dumb fucks.
Yeah.
Dumb. Wait a second. Vin, find out who's the VP of marketing at that company and let's get them on. I'll get them, I'll hook up with them on LinkedIn and we'll have them as a guest caller. That'll be just great. We'll see if they have some balls. And Nabil, yeah, the Thursday night at 9 is now Wednesday at 10. That's the new time slot. And you just missed Waz. You just missed him. and yeah.
But
that's lame. So, I used to go to them all the time when I was
in Oklahoma.
When I used to go to Oklahoma. What the hell were you doing in Oklahoma? That's my question.
Come and goes all through the Midwest from top to bottom.
Yeah. I'm really hoping that White Castle is testing Orlando.
You know, I like White Castle, but I was also raised on it.
But White Castle is good. It's better meat than McDonald's. It's you know, the way they cook it.
Yeah, they cook it with onions.
You know, it's a fresher meat, you know.
Yeah. I think if I were to compare it to, I think it tastes better than McDonald's too.
Low fossil, he would come and go in Oklahoma. Yeah. Listen, I would get them in the freezer section from time to time as a treat and nuke them in the microwave, but it just doesn't have the grease. It's not the same, but it's better than nothing.
Yeah, it's better than nothing. I've had the frozen ones too, because right now the closest White Castle to me is 2.5 hours away in Columbia, Missouri. So I don't usually get it.
Now, do you think they have lead in them? I mean, it's not processed. They cook that shit.
Right. They might, might have lead. It could be a little lard. Who knows?
Yeah. Listen, it's everything in moderation. Whatever.
But back to the, what was it? The maple bacon donut.
Oh, so, is that what it was?
Yeah.
Hang on a second. I'm looking at the. Oh yeah, maple bacon donut. What, Vin? I probably got a Greek omelet. We're on this whole food kick now. Chris with a K. Are you getting hungry from all this bullshit?
I am.
Gary, my brother. He's good for like whipping open a box of Cap'n Crunch at 11:30. He would come home from work, 11:30 midnight. I'd be visiting. You know, he doesn't really acknowledge that I have an eating disorder. We'd eat like an entire big box. We'd blow through the whole box. Cap'n Crunch is out of all the shit cereals, that's my favorite. It's a rite of passage because you cut the roof of your mouth and you're bleeding. So the blood's mixing with the sugar.
It just sets it off.
It's just an incredible experience.
I even like the Oops All Berries.
What is it called?
Oops All Berries. So you know how Captain Crunch has like little berry bites or little bits of berries? Well, this one's all berries.
But all berries.
None of the tan.
Racist.
So, and you can imagine this obviously has more sugar in it. You know?
Right. Right. All right. So Chris says, I'm on my way to White Castle now. Nabil says, 5 minutes to Captain Crunch time here at 11:30, right?
Hey, I also like the Lucky Charms.
Lucky Charms was good. But Cap'n Crunch was back when I was young, back in my day. I remember when granola came out. When granola, like we're talking like in the mid to late 70s, that was like, holy shit, what the hell is this? And it was very, very heavy and very, very dense. And the serving size was like 1/4 of a cup.
Yeah.
I would fill a whole effing bowl with that shit.
It was like
8 billion calories in that.
I was like, it's granola. It's got to be good, even though it tastes like candy, you know?
Right. Vin says, Al, remember when we got... In real life, clickbaited at Universal with the Ghirardelli sign. Yes.
But what did it end up being if it wasn't chocolate?
They didn't have... What were they giving? They were just giving out like caramel? No. It was a facade. It wasn't a real building.
Oh!
We were in Universal Studios at Halloween Horror Nights, and I'm like, damn, I can go for like some Ghirardelli chocolate or whatever. This is at Universal. There's Ghirardelli, Gary, if you're still here, isn't Ghirardelli at Disney Village or whatever it's called? And you hope to get like the mint chocolate, but they give out the caramels because no one really likes the caramel. Like, gosh darn it. I don't want caramel. Oh, Chris is a friend. It's Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Yeah, those are good too. He said it was just scenery. There was no Ghirardelli.
Yeah, no, it was a, what they call it, a facade. It was just the building. It wasn't real.
Oh, that's too bad.
it was too bad. I was like, I was on a mission. Yeah, I want some of this shit.
I will say Russell Stover's is headquartered here.
Oh, okay.
So I'm a little biased, but I love Russell Stover.
Oh, listen, Danny, you've been battling and avoiding type 2 diabetes. You got that shit under control, right?
It's coming back, but yeah, it's still under control.
Why? What do you mean it's coming back? What are you eating?
I had one too many McDonald's recently, so I have to work on it again. My doctor got on to me.
Why are you going to McDonald's? That stuff is dog shit.
It is. It's bad.
It's tasty, though.
It is. And what made me go back, now, I haven't gone back full time like I used to be. Nowhere near that. But I did have it twice in 1 week, and that was a no-no.
Wait. Twice in 1 week was enough to spike in your sugar level?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
What did you have? Do you remember?
Yeah, you know, I got the burger and fries, but that's not why I went. I went because they brought the strawberries and cream pies.
Oh, my effing God.
And they are addictive. I should have never tried one.
You ate a strawberry and cream pie?
I ate two of them, yes.
You fat bastard.
Yeah. He's talking about 50, it's probably 50 grams of sugar a pie is what I'm guessing. I have no idea.
Sure. Oh, but your numbers must
be off. It tasted illegal. I'm telling you that. So.
You want to talk about it? Damn.
Yeah.
Damn.
As I was eating, I was like, oh, this is a felony. If you're a diabetic, this is a felony. So, yeah. It was good, though.
Oh, shit. So, Chris, if you're still here, you know, I sent you the link. Danny sent the link on that Sony. What was the camera?
The Sony ZV-1F is what I use.
The ZV-1F. But see, Danny, though, I asked you, Danny, so, you know, what made the Canon so good? And you said, oh, but how it, you know, has that blurry background. But you could do that in post. Yeah. What's the big deal?
Right. And while that's great, the ZV-1F does it better and quicker and holds focus.
Okay. Listen, I'm still working on the back end stuff, which is that I shipped them a 3 terabyte time capsule that I had here at home. So we're going to set that up in bridge mode. He's going to plug it into the back of his router and then have his, the MacBook Air and the external drive backed up on that, And you know, we just moved his photos library off to an external. So we just got to clear some room. And the internal SSD on the MacBook Air is only, 512. And you take a video and everything, regardless of if you're using the phone or a camera or whatever, it's going to clog that thing up like my arteries. Or like your arteries after two of those freaking pies.
Yeah, I stopped eating those. But yeah.
Sam says, Al, you didn't even think. You just let out that you fat bastard.
It's accountability. We got to do it.
Yeah, that went right through the filter. Yes.
Right.
You gotta call it as it is,
Definitely. So I will say, though, despite that, I had my eye appointment on Monday when the eclipse happened, and my eye doctor said eyes are looking good. There's no blood in the retina. We're still good. Seeing 3 months.
That's good. Now listen, yeah. Danny, also share with the audience, when you were here for 9 days and you were on the diet that I was showing you, didn't you go back with better numbers?
Yeah. I got on the plane on the 9th day, and I read in that morning at 112. So.
And what was it before you got on the plane?
And when I got to your place, it was at 160 or something like that.
Right. So on the diet, from eating the stuff I was cooking here, we went from 160 to 112. That's a good reduction.
Yeah, and that's with the 2 cheat days we had.
Like I said, if you're good, you can have a cheat day. You can have the cheat day. That's you know. Well, listen, I did weight training. I did the weight training at home, and then I did about 20-25 minutes of laps in the pool. You know, swam.
Yeah.
So got in a little cardio. I got in some weight training.
You gotta make sure your cheat day doesn't turn to a cheat week.
Right. Yeah. Dinner was listen. I ate all those sweets last night from the Italian bakery with the 777 Compton zip code on the guy's neck. But you know, dinner tonight was, I just had a protein shake and a little bit of yogurt. I really ate very light because I don't like, you know, being full and belching on the camera.
Right.
Some people at live stream, they're like burping and farting on. It's kind of nasty. I mean, I can give a good belch, but it's kind of gross. Colton says, this is what I found. Ryan Lindsay, come and go senior. All right, here's a guy. No, but we want the marketing director from the guy that's buying come and go.
Right. The Maverick marketing director.
Right. The marketing director from Maverick Marketing. Ryan Lindsley, well, unless they're buying it and they're bringing him on board, I have a feeling it's the marketing director at Maverick.
Right.
Sam says a cheat day is nice, but two whole pies is a cheat year.
No,
He called you out as a cheat year. You need to start posting some food stuff now. We all want to see what you're eating.
So Sam, an apple pie from McDonald's is not a full-blown pie. Think of it as a small burrito. It's about that size.
Speaking of small burrito, when we had movie night, what did we see? We saw the King Kong Godzilla movie. Yeah, Aziz was still observing the Ramadan fast, which just ended tonight. You know, it was whatever, the wrap-up, Eid. We wish a blessed Eid to those that follow the religion.
Yes.
I lean over, I go, Aziz, what time? Because I knew he didn't eat because he follows it very, to protocol, scrotical. Right. So I lean, I said, Aziz, what time is sunset tonight? He goes, Mr. Al, sunset's at 7:40. And at 7:41, he pulls his freaking huge burrito out of his hoodie that he got at Shitpulte. In the movie theater, I was laughing my ass off.
You know he was hungry, too.
Huh?
He he was starving.
Yes. Yeah, of course. Yeah, and
he waited 7:41. He was getting that burrito out.
7:41, the burrito came out. A big bottle of water came out. I said, God bless him. He's growing like,
hey,
boy.
Man, let's eat, you know?
Let's eat, you know? Yeah. All in good fun.
I used to fast every day when I was going to church as a kid. And really? By that, meaning I couldn't wait to eat lunch, you know?
I can't wait. Like, listen, as you know, I have a real problem. By the way, Chris, with a K, is your wife, my lovely niece, is she fast asleep now? Or she's, you know, a baby is gestating in her body? I assume she's sleeping now. She can't be listening to this crap. Still, look at that. She's amazed. My uncle's crazy. Cheat day is nice. Yeah. Danny, stop posting in the food section on the Discord server. Yeah,
I need to.
Yeah,
I need to.
Yeah. She's in and out. Isn't that a burger joint?
Yeah.
Chris said she's in and out. Like, not, right. I'm thinking food. All right. In and out. Burger. Oh, boy.
Yeah, they have good burgers.
Yeah. What lunch was a turkey burger in the air fryer.
Yes, and that was phenomenal.
Yeah, breakfast was Dave's killer whole grain bagel with a little bit of all natural peanut butter.
Right.
So that was the food.
And some oatmeal and fruit.
Yeah. I got to do some food. Well, food shoplifting tomorrow. Actually, I have a 9 a.m. dental appointment to get my new tooth. The implant was successful, and now I get the new tooth.
Nice.
So, I'm looking forward to having the tooth back. Oh my! Nabil says, oh my God, In-N-Outs are delicious. Colton said, this is what I found. Joey Hobson. There you go.
There's the guy.
Chief Mar. All right, I'm going to make an analog. I have a pen. Gasper, are you still here? Okay. Colton, thank you for that. All right, so...
And if you need me...
Joey, I got the headphones down. Hang on a second. Joey, I'm making an actual note. Going to connect with this guy on LinkedIn. Joey Hobson, and he's CMO of Maverick, Inc. Maverick. And do they spell come and go? Is it KUM?
Yeah.
come
and then the and sign and then go.
Huh. Okay.
He's going to ruin a legacy.
I will reach out. You just had to reach around on Stinkton and see if I can get a dialogue, and I'm going to invite him on the show. And look, hey, and Joey, I got to ask you something. Why are you changing the name? Wait,
I have to get in chat and be like, I'll pump somewhere else, sir. You know?
I think that's the whole part of the, you know, people doing selfies in front of the place. I'm sure. Right?
Yeah.
Listen, Danny, when you visit, and Vin, when you visit, we got to do a vlog at Vag Plaza.
Yes.
I've pointed it out. There's a plaza down here, a little bit south of me. It's called Vag Plaza.
That's funny.
It's I think it's supposedly it's pronounced VAG Plaza, but no one says it. We call it Vag Plaza, and it's just funny. Because they tried to sell it, and I said, shit, if I had that type of money to buy an industrial space, I would absolutely keep the name. And what would you put, like I said, what shops would you put in a strip mall in Vag Plaza? You'd put a nail salon?
Nail salon. I would put a OBGYN.
Right. Know? Gynecologist, right? Yeah. What else? Hair?
Hair.
Hair salon.
Yeah.
Right?
Joanne's Fabrics. Why not?
Sex toy shop.
Yeah.
Right? Yep. It's at Planned Parenthood.
I know the Container Store, put one of those in there.
Okay.
So.
Yeah.
These are all like female-oriented shops, you know. Peter says an abortion clinic. There you go.
I'll tell you, but if you go into Google and you type in Vag Plaza, it's internet famous. There are pictures of people standing in front of the sign. And so
Speaking of, there's one thing I wanted to mention real quick with come and go in a certain location.
Was this a segue from Vag Plaza to come and go?
It reminded me of something.
Yeah, and you wonder why YouTube shadow bans this show. Best show on the internet. Best show. Go ahead. Oh, well, Pete said plastic surgeon also. Yeah, throw that in there too. Go ahead.
There's a come and go in Springfield, Missouri, across the street from a come and go. And also in Springfield, Missouri. It's the funniest thing.
Wait, say it again?
There's a come and go across the street from a come and go in Springfield, Missouri.
They're across the street from each other?
Yeah, I'm trying to find it.
It doesn't make sense because as a franchise owner, you know, they protect, you know, a radius around the store unless it's the same franchise owner. And because of the traffic, he's getting both the north and southbound or the east and westbound.
Can I post this in chat? I have the link.
Yeah, go ahead.
To show. They made a whole article on it because, you know, Springfield, Missouri is not very big. So what else
they
talk
share
about?
The article. I don't know. I think you have.
There it is.
Yeah. Okay. Huh. I got to save that. All right, Chris, thank you for tuning in. I'll talk to you tomorrow when we hook up that time capsule and tell my little angel, my favorite, Alexa, I said goodnight, and I will talk to you. All right, I want to save this article because I do want to look at it to get a little context. There's a little bit more info on that.
Yeah, I could tell you right real quick if you want me to.
I'm sorry, say again.
Yes, I can tell you why if you want me to.
Okay, yeah.
So this intersection is a little chaotic where these two come and goes are. The way they're built, one is a one-way. One lane is a one-way, and one way is not a one-way, if that makes sense. So the flow, to keep the flow of traffic from becoming congested, they, in 2009, built a second come-and-go next to the first come-and-go where the one-way is. So you got people on both sides going both ways, able to get to a come-and-go. That's the only reason why they put one.
All right, so I was right. And yeah. Alexa, get some sleep. So my great nephew will be grow up to be a good, smart, strong man. Get your rest. You're pregnant. We have the ongoing joke was obviously, you're my favorite niece, and then when she got to about 16 years of age, she's like, hey, wait a minute. I'm your only niece. So we have fun with that. But that's see, funny. Now, Chris with a K is my favorite nephew-in-law. My only nephew-in-law. Yeah, it works. What the hell? Vin said the one on the north side's better.
Right.
It's like a civil war. Oh,
right.
Shit.
But it's so they don't mess up the flow of traffic, so there's no traffic jam.
Okay. Is it the same owner, though?
No.
Oh, it's not the same owner?
No.
Okay.
Two different owners, both franchised out. What's okay. funny is one has a digital sign for gas, and one has a – we had to go out there with a little rake thing and put up the new price. I'm like, oh, it's not good.
a little old school.
Right, yeah.
Oh, shit. All in good fun. So, anyway, Danny, it's 11:42, and I got to be on point for the dentist tomorrow. So I'm going to get gonna strap on the CPAP mask and get some sleep. I thank you for calling in. I thank Vin for calling in. I thank this fine, sophisticated, mature, educated, tech-centric audience. But tuning in, Vince says, what color tooth? I discussed that. I asked her if I can get one that was blue so I can say I have Bluetooth. And he said, yeah, we can make whatever color you want.
Can they really?
So she might have been just going along with the joke.
Oh, okay.
But I don't know, you know.
I'm like, do you have one with RGB? Yeah. RGB teeth?
That would be good.
I wanted to sync it with my gaming PC.
You're sync it right. Sync it with your gaming PC. Oh, God. All right, Danny, listen, thank you for calling in and thank you for sharing some good stories and a few good laughs. And I will I will talk to you.
All right. See you later.
Take care, Danny. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Great Danny Minnick. And again, we thank Vin Doria. And we thank you all for tuning in. Again, Wednesday nights at 10 p.m., though I got a birthday night with Aziz and a few other friends, so I'll let you know if I skip next Wednesday. Stay tuned. Mendota says knock it off. But yeah, thanks for tuning in. I hope you had a few laughs and a few smiles. We will have to call William Hummel. Someone remind me on that one. We have to ask him how many nosebleeds he had and how many cough clouds he walked into. And Vin says movie night, Alien, the original. On Monday on the Discord server. So make sure you tune in. So y'all have a great night. I'm going to throw up the peace sign. See you next time. Take care, everyone. How do I end this shit? It's always a freaking problem. I gotta press buttons somewhere.